courtroom drama caught on camera in the United States. This happened in Clark County, where presiding judge Mary Kay Holthus was about to issue her decision on prison time for convicted felon Debbie Redden. But she did not get a chance to do this when Redden jumped up to the bench and made a flying tackle on the judge. Court personnel immediately dragged Redden away. Before the attack, Redden was asking the court for leniency, saying he had been suffering from a mental illness.
Indonesian President Joko Widodo set to arrive in the Philippines for a two-day official visit. Widodo will be in the country beginning January 9th in a bid to strengthen Jakarta's political and economic ties with Manila. President Marcos is set to meet Widodo on January 10 to take stock of progress made since Marcos visited Indonesia last September. The two leaders are expected to reaffirm their commitment to deepen ties as the countries celebrate their 75th anniversary of formal diplomatic relations in November. A former Philippine provincial governor loses a bid to drop the charges against him over the alleged misuse of funds from the Malampaya gas project off Palawan. A Wednesday ruling by the Sandiganbayan Anti-Graft Court junked a petition of former Palawan Governor Mario Joel Reyes for lack of evidence. Reyes and his subordinates were accused of irregularities in handling the fund that amounted to 1.5 billion pesos. He was indicted in 2017 on 36 counts of graft over the anomalous construction projects funded by royalties from the Malampaya. He insisted he had no part in the project bidding as then governor of the province, but the court said it saw no reason to grant the motion after a review of the records and the evidence presented by the prosecution.
The Philippine National Security Council slams the communist movement for pursuing its armed struggle against the government despite ongoing exploratory peace talks. Its Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says a statement from the Communist Party calling for a third rectification movement casts doubt over its sincerity in the negotiating table. He adds, should a third rectification movement occur within the Revolutionary Party, it should build a foundation for lasting peace and transition the CPP-NPA from an armed group to a political movement.
It is a great concern because it is an official document coming from the Communist Party of the Philippines. And it actually states and calls for a third rectification movement. The exploratory talks do not succeed. It will not be the fault of government. It will be because of the insincerity and duplicity coming from the other side.
Other news, Philippine transport officials assure the public there will be no hike in jeepney fares amid the PUV modernization program. Think tank Ibon Foundation earlier warned fares may hit 45 to 50 pesos in a few years as operators struggle to pay for modern jeepneys. But Transport Undersecretary Timothy Batan says these concerns for a fare hike are without basis.
Wala pong taas pasahe na mangyayari na hindi po dumadaan sa proseso ng LTFRB. At ito pong pag-implementa ng ating consolidation deadline ay hindi po inaasahan na magkakaroon ng kaakibat na taas pasahe ngayon pong panahon na ito.
Philippine senators, meanwhile, seek a government probe of the power outages in Western Visayas. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said the situation is intolerable and urged the grid operator to address the issue. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva warned of its effect on the economy and called for measures to prevent a repeat of the outages. As for Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, he said he will file a resolution to investigate the matter, citing potential economic losses from the disruptions. Meanwhile, Congresswoman Franz Castro believes the national grid operator should be held accountable for the blackout in Panay as well as in some parts of Negros Islands.
1.5 billion pesos, that's how much money the Philippine city of Iloilo has lost due to the total power blackout affecting Panay Island and nearby provinces. Iloilo Mayor Jerry Treña says a massive power outage costs the city up to 500 million pesos per day. According to the Energy Department, around 400 megawatts is needed to restore stable power in the island. The National Grid Corporation said as of 3 p.m. today, 241 megawatts is being served by Panay power plants and other sources in Visayas. The DOE now saying it is ready to face a probe into the blackout.
Bukas po ang kagawaran ng enerhiya sa ganitong pong investigasyon para po maliwanagan at mabigyan po ng pansin ang mga sitwasyon na nangyayari. Patuloy po ang pagdangalap natin ng mga datos. Hindi po po natin masabi kung saan ang kung sino at kung saan nagmula ang pagkakaroon ng outage sa Visayas.